Hello friends, I am Mr. Ravindra Bhalerao and I welcome you to my channel that is English for Learners. Friends, today we are going to learn one of the best motivational speech given by Nobel Peace Award winner that is Kailash Satyarthi. But before watching his speech, don't forget to subscribe my channel. The name of the topic is Let's March.
We can do it. You may ask that what one person can do. I could recall a story of my childhood. I was telling you the story of my child, what I remember from my childhood. A heavy fire broken out in jungle, in forest. Everybody was running away, including lion, the king of forest. Suddenly he saw a bird rushing straight to the fire. He asked the bird, "What are you doing?" Bird said, "I am going to extinguish the fire." Lion laughed and said, "How can you do it? Keeping just one drop of water in your beak?" But the bird was adamant. She said, "I am doing my bit." Years ago, millions of people, individuals, marched across the globe. They demanded a new international law for the abolition of worst forms of child labor, and it has happened. We did it. Millions of individuals together did it. Friends, we live in an age of rapid globalization. We are connected through high-speed internet. We exchange our goods and services in one single global market. Thousands of flights every day connect us from one corner to another corner of the globe. But there is one serious disconnect. And that is the lack of compassion. Let us inculcate and transform the individual's compassion into global compassion. Let us globalize compassion. Mahatma Gandhi said, if we are to teach real peace to the world, we shall have to begin with the children. I humbly add, let us unite the world through the compassion for our children. I ask, whose children are they who stitch footballs, yet never played with one? Whose children are they who harvest cocoa, but have never tasted a chocolate? Whose children are they who are dying of Ebola? Whose children are they who are kidnapped and made hostage today? They are all our children. I remember an 8-year-old girl rescued from intergenerational forced labor from a stone quarry. When she was sitting with me in my car, right after the rescue, she asked me, "Why did you not come early?" Her angry question still shakes me and has the power to shake the whole world. What are we doing? What are we waiting for? How many girls will we allow to go without rescue? Children are questioning. Children are questioning our inaction and watching our action. We need collective action with the sense of urgency. Every single minute matters. Every single child matters. Every single childhood matters. Therefore, I challenge the passivity and pessimism surrounding our children. I challenge the culture of silence and a culture of passivity, the culture of neutrality. I call upon the governments and intergovernmental agencies, businesses, workers, teachers, NGOs, faith leaders, and each one of us to put an end to all forms of violence against children. Slavery, trafficking, child labor, child marriages, child sexual abuse, illiteracy. These things have no place in any civilized society. Friends, we can do this. Governments must make child-friendly policies and invest in education and young people. The businesses must be more responsible, accountable, and innovative, ready to innovative partnerships. Intergovernmental agencies must work together to accelerate action. Global civil society must rise above the businesses as usual and fragmented agendas. Faith leaders, institutions, and all of us must stand with our children. We must be bold, we must be ambitious, and we must have the will. We must keep our promises. Over 50 years ago, on the first day of my school, I met a boy, a cobbler boy, sitting outside the gate of my school. I asked to my teacher, "Why is he sitting outside? Why is he not with us in the classroom?" He had no answer. One day I gathered all my courage and straight went to the father of that cobbler boy. And he said, "Sir, I have never thought about it. We are born to work." His answer made me angry, and it still makes me angry. As a child, I had a vision of tomorrow, a vision that a cobbler boy is sitting with me in my classroom. Now, the tomorrow has become today. I am today. You are today. Today is the time for every child to have the right to life, right to freedom, right to health, right to education, right to safety, right to dignity, right to equality, and right to peace. Today, beyond the darkness, I see the smiling faces of children in blinking stars. Today, in every wave of every ocean, I see my children are playing and dancing. Today, in every plant, in every tree, in every mountain, I see children are growing freely with dignity. Friends, I want to see and feel this today inside you. My dear sisters and brothers, as I said, many interesting things are happening today. But may I request you to put your hand close to your heart . Close your eyes and feel the child inside you. I am sure you can. Listen to that child. Listen, please. Today, I see thousands of Mahatma Gandhis, Nelson Mandelas, Martin Luther Kings calling on us. Let us democratize knowledge. Let us universalize justice. Together, let us globalize compassion. I call upon you in this room and all across the world. I call for a march from exploitation to education. I call for a march from poverty to shared prosperity, a march from slavery to liberty, and a march from violence to peace. Asato ma sadgamay, tamaso ma jyotirgamay, mrityor ma amritam gamay. Let us march from ignorance to awakening. Let us march from darkness to light. Let us march from mortality to divinity. Let us march. Thank you.
Friends, I hope you might have liked this video. If you liked it, please share it. If you have any suggestions for me, please write in comment box. Wish you good day. Thank you very much.